Welcome back to English at Work. Last time we heard Anna pitching her new plastic aubergine idea to Paul in a lift. He was on his way to a biscuit lovers convention and didn't have much time. She gave the perfect elevator pitch, but it's down to Paul to give her idea the go-ahead. The problem is, he seems to have gone missing.
Denise, isn't Paul supposed to be here today?
Yes. He went to that biscuit lovers convention yesterday, but he said he'd be back today.
Maybe he's eloped with a pack of custard creams, eh?
Very funny, Tom. I'll give him a call now. Oh, that might be him. Hello, Tip Top Trading. Oh, hello, Paul. Everything okay? Oh, no. Oh, no.
What, Denise? What's he saying?
He choked on a biscuit at the convention and he's in hospital. Yes, Paul, that was Tom. You want to speak to Anna? I'll just get her. Get better soon, Paul. Anna! Anna! It's Paul on the phone. He wants to speak to you. Sounds important.
Me? All right. Can you transfer the call, please? Hello, Paul. Are you okay?
Not really. Damn Garibaldi biscuit got wedged in my throat. Ended up banging my head on a table trying to get it out.
Oh, dear. So you're not coming to work today?
I'm afraid not. I need to rest for a few days. So I was wondering... In fact, I'm asking you, could you act up?
I've told you before, Paul. I can't act. Or even sing.
No, no, Anna. Act up. I mean, do my job for a bit. Be the boss. Just for a day or two.
Me? Be the boss?
What?
It's quite easy, really. Just check my diary and you'll see what needs doing. And if you have any problems, just ask Denise. Thanks, Anna.
That's great, Anna. You've got all the skills to do Paul's job, maybe even more. But you need to take charge and show who's boss.
Oh, right. But what should I say?
Well, don't be too bossy. But you could say, if anyone has any issues about their work, please come and speak to me. Or, I would like to have a meeting to discuss our work. Or... if there's anything you want to ask, my door is always open. That makes you sound like a very approachable boss. Good luck!
Thanks. Right, everyone. As you know, Paul has put me in charge for a while.
I'm not being funny, Anna, but why you? I mean, I've been here the longest.
Tom, if you have any issues about your work, please come and speak to me.
Oh, right. I will then.
Anna, congratulations on your promotion. I just wondered, now you're in charge, could I do a little less admin and a bit more selling?
Let's see, Denise. I'd like to have a meeting soon to discuss all our work, so we can talk about it then, okay?
Oh, yes. Thanks, Anna.
Right then, it's business as usual, and if there's anything you want to ask, my door is always open. Right, back to work. And Tom, could I have a word in my office now, please?
Excellent work, Anna. You're sounding like the boss already. Just don't start eating biscuits. Being in charge means being firm but fair and keeping your cool. Here's a reminder of some of the phrases Anna used.
If anyone has any issues about their work, please come and speak to me. I would like to have a meeting to discuss our work. If there is anything you want to ask, my door is always open. Take a seat, Tom. Could you please close the door?
I thought your door was always open.
Not this time. I need to speak to you about this message in Paul's diary.
Oh, right, I see. You need my help. What does it say?
It's for 2 days' time, and it says, Socrates, IPC, final.
Oh, no. That doesn't sound good.
Oh, dear. What could that mean? Could there be trouble ahead? Join us again soon to find out. Bye! Welcome back to English at Work. Anna is acting up as boss because Paul had an accident with a biscuit. But her and Tom are in a panic after finding a note in Paul's diary that said, Socrates, IPC, final. Could it mean bad news for tip-top trading? Let's find out.
It's very odd, and it can't be good. But Socrates must mean Mr. Socrates.
Yes, but IPC? What's that mean?
Yeah, and final sounds very final. Oh, I've got it. IPC. It must be code for imminent post-closures. They're going to sack us all.
Shh. Keep your voice down. Don't tell everyone. Let's check things out first. Don't say anything yet, OK?
OK. Mum's the word.
Your mum knows?
No, no, no. It's our little secret. See you later.
Everything okay, Tom?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, everything's cool. Actually, Denise, it's not. I think we're all going to be sacked tomorrow by Mr. Socrates.
What? No. I've got a hairdresser's appointment on Saturday. How am I going to pay for it now? What am I going to do? I know. I'll call Marge.
Hey, Brian, Pete. We're all going to be sacked tomorrow.
Anna, you've got a problem brewing.
What?
Tom's spreading rumours about job cuts. Everyone's starting to panic.
Oh, no. I'd better do something. But what shall I say?
Call a meeting quickly. Tell the team there are some rumours going around that are not true. Say, I'm trying to establish the facts and I'll let you know as soon as I have some information. You could say, I would be grateful if you hear any rumours not to pass them on. This can be a tricky situation and you need to handle it well. Good luck!
Gosh, this is hard, but here goes. Excuse me, could everyone gather round, please?
Is this about the sackings?
No, Denise. Any rumours about sackings are not true.
Yeah, that's right. Who told you that, Denise?
Please don't listen to rumours. I'm trying to establish the facts, and if I get any information, I will let you know straight away.
But I heard Mr. Socrates is coming tomorrow. Surely he's going to sack us.
Ignore the rumours, and please don't pass them on.
Psst. Psst, Anna. Tell them to carry on with their work as normal.
Right, yes. Could you please just carry on with your work as normal? Thank you.
So, Anna, how are you going to find out the facts?
I'm going to have to call Paul. In private, Tom. I don't want any more rumours getting out.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You need to establish the facts, right?
Hello, Paul speaking.
Oh, hi, Paul. It's Anna. Sorry to bother you. Are you feeling better?
Much better, thanks. But keeping clear of biscuits for a while. Anyway, is everything okay?
Not exactly. There are rumours spreading about job cuts. Tom saw a note in your diary for tomorrow that said, Socrates, IPC.
Really? Oh, yes. It's not job cuts, it's IPC, the International Plastics Conference, tomorrow. And Mr. Socrates is flying in for it. Oh, golly gosh, I'd forgotten about that.
I see. And why did you write final?
Because there's an award being given for the best plastic innovation. And we're in the final with our Imperial Lemon. It was a reminder to me to write an acceptance speech. Oh, golly gosh, I haven't written a thing.
Oh, dear. What are we going to do?
What are you going to do indeed? But thank goodness those rumours of job cuts are not true. Tomorrow could actually be a good day for tip-top trading. Here's a reminder of the phrases Anna used to try and control the spread of some office rumours.
There are some rumours going around that are not true. Please don't listen to rumours. I'm trying to establish the facts, and if I get any information, I will let you know straight away. Ignore the rumours and please don't pass them on. Please just carry on with your work as normal. Thank you.
Tomorrow is going to be an important day at the International Plastics Conference. Mr. Socrates will be there and Tip Top Trading could pick up a prestigious prize. But who's going to write the acceptance speech?
OK, Anna, this calls for some urgent action. I want you and Tom to meet me at the Princess Diana Conference Centre tomorrow at 9.
Right. And what about the speech?
Well, I've got quite a lot on my plate, so I was wondering if you could give it a go. Please?
Me? I've never done it before. What am I going to say?
Don't worry, Anna. We're here to help. Join us again soon for some more English at Work. Bye! Welcome back to English at Work. It's the big day of the International Plastics Conference and a good opportunity for the staff at Tip Top Trading to promote its business. But hold on, who's this? It's Mr. Socrates, the big boss from America.
Hey, you guys, where you been?
Mr. Socrates, nice to see you again. I'd heard you were in town.
Hello, Mr. Socrates.
I've been looking for you everywhere. I need to catch up with you and see how business is going.
Oh, very, very well. We're selling Imperial Lemons to France, and Anna is developing plastic vegetables.
Ah, Anna, my favorite girl. Still doing a good job?
I'm doing my best.
In fact, she's been doing my job for a few days. Had a bit of a biscuit accident.
Yeah, well, that's not hard for you, Paul. Listen, I need to talk to you. Shouldn't the others be doing some networking now?
Of course. That's why we're here. Right, Tom, I need you to catch up with some of our existing customers. Do some schmoozing. And Anna, could you talk to some potential new customers? I need to speak to Mr. Socrates.
Right. Networking. What exactly am I supposed to do?
Networking is about helping your business through connecting with other people in the industry. It involves meeting people and talking to them, sharing information, hopefully helping each other and ultimately getting new business.
So I have to talk to strangers?
Well, yes. Introduce yourself. Say who you work for. Ask them about their business and what they do. Then explain a bit about what you do and who uses your products. If it's appropriate, say that you may be able to help them. Then see if they would consider buying from you. Just be chatty and friendly.
Thanks. I'll give it a try. Excuse me. Hello, I'm Anna. I work as a sales executive at Tip Top Trading. And you are?
Jane. Jane from Nice and Cheesy. It's very busy here today, isn't it?
It is. It's my first time here, but it's very exciting. I really didn't know what to wear.
Anna, that's chatty and friendly, but let's get down to business.
Oh, yes, of course. So, can you tell me about your company, Nice and Cheesy?
Well, we sell cheese to London's top cheese shops. We like to say we're a wedge above the rest. A wedge of cheese. Get it?
Right. Well, can I briefly tell you about what our company does? Our company, tip-top trading, makes plastic fruit mainly for the catering and food industry. We're up for an award today for one of our designs.
Smashing? That's quite interesting, actually. We have an issue with the fresh grapes we provide with our cheeses. They keep going mouldy.
Oh, dear.
Yes, sour grapes, you could say. A good quality plastic grape would be useful to put with our cheese displays.
Well, I think we might be able to help you.
Yes, you can. This is the time to exchange contact details. Give her your business card.
Well, if I could have your contact details, I'll send you one of our brochures and then give you a call about prices. And here's my business card should you want to call me.
That's fantastic. So nice to have met you. And I think what you're wearing for the conference is perfect.
Thanks.
Bingo! Looks like Anna has a potential new customer. She was friendly and chatty but kept her mind on business. She used phrases like these.
Excuse me. Hello, I'm Anna. I work as a sales executive at Tip Top Trading. Can you tell me about your company? Can I briefly tell you about what our company does? I think we might be able to help you. Here's my business card should you want to call.
So, some good work by Anna. But there's more networking to be done. A conference is a good place for networking and for catching up with your boss too. Let's find out how Paul is getting on with Mr. Socrates.
It's a tough economic climate, Paul. We're already cutting out cookies in management meetings.
Oh gosh.
And now we're cutting staff. We've already lost Rachel, my favorite sales executive.
Yes, well, she was stealing the pens.
Pens can be replaced, but not people like her.
Well...
But now it's time to reduce your team, Paul. Share the pain.
Are you sure?
Absolutely. By my calculations, you need to be rid of one member of staff.
Oh, well, let's not tell the team until we've had the award ceremony.
Okay, Paul. But it's in your hands to sort this out.
Crumbs.
Ah, yes. Tip Top Trading could be about to win a prestigious award. But how will this bad news go down with the team? And what is Paul going to do? Find out next time on English at Work. Welcome back to English at Work. Paul, Anna, and Tom are at an important international plastics conference. It's been a busy day of networking. But the big boss from America, Mr. Socrates, has told Paul some bad news. Before he tells the team, there's an important award to be won. The Plastic Innovation of the Year Award. Will Tip Top Trading win it? I hope you've written your acceptance speech, Anna.
Yes, I'm just doing it now.
You've left it a bit late.
I've been so busy, and now I'm really struggling. I don't know what to write.
Well, don't forget to say, on behalf of everyone at Tip Top Trading, thank you for our award. Or you could say, our company is at the forefront of plastic innovation. Tell the audience, this award is a real boost for everyone working at the company. Say that and you'll be fine.
Working at the company. Good, got it. Thanks. Oh, hi, Tom. How have you got on?
Great. Yeah, I've been hanging out with some of our clients, keeping them sweet, you know what I mean?
I don't actually know. But I've had some success. Oh, here comes Paul. Hi, Paul.
Oh, hello. Having a good day?
Yes, we're just talking about our success. Let's hope we win that Plastic Innovation of the Year award, eh?
Oh, yes. Let's hope so. Although that means I've got to read out that speech you wrote for me. Public speaking is not really one of my things.
Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats for our special award ceremony.
Okay, here's your speech, Paul.
We've got to win first.
Shh, listen.
Thank you, everyone, for attending this year's conference. As you know, The highlight of the day is announcing the winner of our Plastic Innovation Award. So, without further ado, let's find out who this year's winner is. It is Tip Top Trading for their Imperial Lemon.
Hey, that's us. We've actually won.
Oh, crumbs. I suppose I'd better do my speech now.
Yeah, go on, Paul. You could do it.
OK, right. Whoa!
Ow! Oh, no. Paul stripped over that chair.
Oh.
Is there anyone from Tip Top Trading here?
Anna, you'll have to do the speech. You did write it, after all.
What? Me? I can't.
Oh. Go on. You'll be fine. And besides, I'm no good at public speaking.
Yes, you can do it, Anna. Just start by saying, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, if I have to. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of everyone at Tip Top Trading, thank you for our award. Our company is at the forefront of plastic innovation.
Yay!
Thanks, Tom. This award is a real boost for everyone working at the company. We pride ourselves on innovation, quality, and plastic fruit. And coming soon, we'll be launching a new plastic aubergine.
Ow, my big toe.
So, thank you, everyone. This really means a lot to us.
Brilliant, Anna.
Yes, splendid. Well done, Anna.
Well done indeed. Anna saved the day again by making that speech. She sounded confident and genuinely happy about getting the award. Here's a reminder of some of the things she said.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of everyone at Tip Top Trading, thank you for our award. Our company is at the forefront of plastic innovation. This award is a real boost for everyone working at the company. This award really means a lot to us. Are you okay now, Paul?
Yes, sorry. That was rather unfortunate and a bit embarrassing too. But hold on. What's happening now?
Ladies and gentlemen, before you go, we have one more award to present.
Ooh!
We have a special award, Employee of the Year. This recognises someone's achievements and contribution to the plastics industry.
At last, I've been recognised.
Please welcome Brad Socrates from Tip Top Trading International to award the prize.
Out the way. Where's the goddamn envelope? Okay, right. And the award goes to Anna from Tip Top Trading.
Me? But I...
Go on, Anna. You deserve it. Go and make another speech.
Thank you, everyone. This is amazing!
This girl is amazing. In just 1 year, she has risen from an apprentice to a champion. It's great to have her on board.
I think we should talk about your salary later, hey?
Can things get any better for Anna? I think they can. Join us again soon for more English at Work. Bye!
Everyone, how did you get on at the conference?
Oh, hi Denise. Yeah, it was okay.
What do you mean okay? It was great. We made some new contacts and we won an award. Best Plastic Innovation of the Year for our Imperial Lemon.
Oh, that's wonderful. Wish I'd been there.
Maybe next year, eh?
Maybe. Welcome back to the offices of Tip Top Trading, where everyone's catching up on yesterday's good news. But today it's bad news that everyone's going to hear following Paul's chat with the big boss, Mr. Socrates. But how bad is it? Let's find out.
Morning, everyone.
Hi, Paul. Everything okay?
Yes, fine. Well done for winning Employee of the Year. I hope you can continue to be a great employee. Excuse me.
He sounded odd. What did he mean?
Probably just run out of biscuits.
He's obviously got something on his mind.
Denise, could I have a word with you in my office, please?
Of course. I'll bring my notepad and pen, shall I?
What's that all about? Anyway, now we're alone, I wanted to see what you're doing tonight. Are you free?
Sorry, Tom. I'm seeing Dave tonight. He's offered to fix something on my computer at home.
Oh, has he now?
All the years I've worked here. Why me? Why now?
Denise, what's up?
Paul says he needs to move the furniture around and he has to let me go. He says he can't afford me anymore.
That's terrible. But where's he letting you go to? And what furniture is he moving?
No, Anna. If someone says they're moving the furniture, they really mean they're restructuring or changing the business. And if they say they have to let you go, it means they're sacking you, or in other words, ending your job.
Sacking you? Oh, that is serious. Denise, I'm really sorry to hear this. But why does Paul want to move the furniture around?
He says it's because of the tough economic situation. My role is no longer needed.
Hey, that's not true. You make a great cup of tea, Denise. I've got a good mind to smash Paul's bourbons into tiny crumbs.
Calm down, Tom. Now, Denise, when did Paul say you had to go?
He's given me 7 days' notice.
A notice period is an amount of time an employer must give an employee if they plan to terminate their employment.
I never thought I would be facing redundancy. Not now. Not at my age.
Redundancy?
Yes. If someone says they're facing redundancy, it's another way of saying they're losing their job. I think Denise needs a shoulder to cry on.
Yes. Denise, do you want my shoulder to cry on?
Oh, thanks.
Denise, I've just made some tea. Would you like a cup?
Oh, yes, please.
Here you go. You know, Denise, you've got to think positively. You'll get another job. And let's face it, you didn't like working here anyway. You always look so miserable.
I don't think Tom's attempts to cheer Denise up are going to work. Losing your job can be a traumatic experience. It can come as a surprise and a shock. Let's hear the phrases Paul used to break the news to Denise.
We've got to move the furniture around. I'm afraid I've got to let you go. I'm giving you 7 days' notice.
And here are some other expressions you may hear in connection with losing your job.
Facing redundancy. Getting the sack. Terminating your employment. Leaving the company.
Right, well, I might as well start clearing out my desk.
Yeah, it's a real shame. Any chance I could have your stapler?
Tom, you could be a bit more sympathetic.
Oh, right.
Tom, Anna, could I have a word in my office, please?
Oh, no. This is it. It's my turn to get the chop.
Ha, you might not need my stapler after all.
Crikey, things aren't looking good at Tip Top Trading. Are Tom and Anna getting the chop? The sack? Join us again next time on English at Work.